So today, about 13:47 hours, we received a call here at 53 West Vine Street in the parking lot of the Mighty Wings. We were reported a disturbance that happened in the parking lot, and what we've learned so far is that there were shots exchanged, which led to two males being shot. We also learned that there was another male who was traveling east on 192, and his vehicle was, there was a stray bullet that went through his vehicle, through the driver's side, out through the passenger side. He was injured, but they don't appear life-threatening. What we do know is that one of the males is deceased, but we are not releasing any of his information until we notify his next of kin. Okay. That's really all I can do. Anybody have any questions right now that I can answer? I'm sorry?
No one's in custody?
No one's in custody yet. We are still investigating all of that information. It does appear to be an isolated incident. So our detectives are working very diligently to identify and, you know, hopefully arrest someone within, you know, a reasonable amount of time. The deceased male was one of the men who were shooting at each other outside of the wings. That's what it appears to be, yes, ma'am. We do not know how it started or why it started. We were just called. Sorry. We were called based on a disturbance that was happening in the parking lot.
How many guns did you recover?
I'm not at liberty to say right yet.
Mm-hmm. Do you have the age range? Were these young men? They look like in their 20s, 30s, or older?
We don't have an age on them yet. Like I say, detectives are still working on this, and we're gathering information, and as soon as we can release that, we will.
And the driver that was hit by the stray bullet, he was driving along Vine Street, headed east?
Yes, he was actually, I don't know if it's his personal vehicle or if it's a business vehicle, but he was traveling east, and just a stray bullet, it looked like it went through the driver's side and exited the passenger side. I don't know if he was injured with the stray bullet or was it glass breakage. We don't know that yet. They're both being treated right now for their injuries at the hospital.
Was there any surveillance video that captured the shooting, maybe at the business itself or someone nearby?
I don't want to release that just yet, but as soon as we gather that information, we'll definitely make sure we keep you guys up to date.
And you said two men are suffering gunshot wounds, but there were more people involved in the exchange of gunfire, right?
We don't know that yet. Like I say, we're still gathering all the evidence, if there are any videos, and then we will determine exactly how many people have been involved.
This is a shopping plaza. Were they at any of the stores or the wing shop? Were they customers and came out in the lot and had an incident?
So it appears they may have been customers into one of the shops. We have not verified yet. All I do know is they were in the parking lot when the gunfire exchanged.
You have a lot of evidence markers on the ground. Do you know how many shell cases you guys found that you're able to show that?
A lot, but I don't know how many that is. There are several, and until our crime scene technicians are able to process the scene, we won't know exactly how many until that's completed.
How can you find a lot? Like more than 10, more than 5?
It appears to be more than 10.
A bit of an odd question. There's a clump in the middle of the road over here by the evidence markers. Is that clothing? Can you tell us what we're looking at? We just can't see close.
I do believe it's closed from where the first responders for the fire department had came and worked on one of the victims. So, mm-hmm. Any other questions?
Can I hear what you said about how old the stranger?
I don't have his age yet.
Mm-hmm. Can you give me your full name, please?
Yes, it's Betty, Betty Holland, Holland.
Okay.
I do not have their ages as of yet. Honestly, I do not know. No.
The agencies that responded, was it just KPD? I know that you've got your forensics out here.
Yes, yeah, so it was KPD, obviously the fire department from the Kissimmee, city of Kissimmee. The sheriff's office did respond to help us with the traffic because, as you see, 192 and Main is a very busy intersection. So they did come and help assist with some of the road closures and things like that.
All the roads have been reopened?
Yes, ma'am.
What's your reaction to just hearing something like this in a highly populated area, strip mall, and then on top of it, someone struck by a stray bullet in traffic?
Well, we don't know if it was a stray bullet or if it was the glass that actually injured that person. But, you know, it's disheartening. Obviously, there's a lot of innocent people that visit this area, and you know, it's just a miracle that nobody else got hurt. So
we confirmed that a bullet hit a passing car.
It looks like a stray bullet did hit a passing car. Yes, ma'am.